Summary reports are your way of taking a lot of data and making it more readable. Let's take a look at a couple of summary reports by going to the Reports Center. The balance sheet and the profit and loss, which are your two primary financial statements, are both examples of summary reports. Looking at a profit and loss report, you see the balances for your income, cost of goods sold, and expense accounts right here. And these balances are made up of all the transactions which took place between these two dates and included these various accounts. But you don't see any of the actual transactions that make up these totals. However, one of the characteristics of a summary report is that you can click on these numbers to actually zoom into a detail report, which gives you the actual transactions that make up the totals. Going back over to the Reports Center, there are many other summary reports which are very useful for a business. For instance, the sales by customer summary is something that many businesses will run to see what their sales were by customer. One of the things that you can do with a summary report, but you can't do with most other reports, is you can change up the columns so that you can compare different periods of time or different data sets against one another. Right here, for instance, instead of only having a total column, you could instead have columns for days, weeks, months, quarters, years, customers, or products and services. So if we choose months right here, and then change the date range to this quarter, and then run the report again, we get a report that shows all of our sales for January, February, and March, because these are each individual months over the course of the selected quarter. This is a unique quality of summary reports, and is very helpful in determining trends that are taking place in your business. Up at the very top, there's also a customize button. And from the general area, you can customize information such as the date range or how numbers are formatted. But there's also a place right here where you can customize your rows and columns, as well as add filters, so you can change the data that's actually being displayed on the report. Use summary reports when you want to look at your business more broadly and you don't care to see individual transactions.